إن الحمد لله والصلاة والسلام على رسول الله. This is our second part of our lecture. السفر متطلبات requirements of a safar in Islam. We reach in the seventh point. Al-bukuru fi safari. When we are traveling, to travel earlier on the day. In Sahih Abi Dawood, عن سحر الغامدي عن النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم قال اللهم بارك لأمتي في بكورها أو الله bless for my ummah in the early morning. What do you do early morning? We go back to sleep, isn't it? That's why we don't have barakah. Early morning means pray you fajr and then start your day. You are farming, you are restaurant, you are cleaning, you are carving, whatever. Start in the morning. Don't wait late. The prayer for the risk is to start in the morning. Sometimes we pray 4 o'clock. We say, no, I'm sleeping until 8. Start 4 o'clock when you pray Fajr. That's a bukur. 8 o'clock is a bukur. That's a prayer. And the Prophet has implemented that in his life. وكان إذا بعث سرية أو جيشاً، فمبروس عصام was sending an army. What he does, بعثهم في أول النهار، he sent them at the earlier of the day. Early of the day. Who narrated the hadith? صح. الغامدي. So look to this man. He read a hadith, Prophet ﷺ, and he wanted to implement that hadith. وَكَانَ سَخْرٌ رَجُلًا تَاجِرًا. Sahr was merchant, trade. So what he does, وَكَانَ يَبْعَثُ تِجَارَةٌ مِنْ أَوْلِ النَّهَارِ. He used to send his goods at the earlier of the day. Why? Because of the hadith of Prophet ﷺ. He wanted to implement. So what happened? فَأَثْرَى وَكَثْرَ مَالَهُ. Yes, he earned a lot and his wealth increased. Because this is ibadah, you implement the hadith of Prophet, that's ibadah itself. The day of the leaving, Prophet used to select certain day to leave for his travel. Al-Khuruj fi yawm al-Khamis. Used to leave or travel starting on the Saturday days. Don't say, there's prak on Friday, I'm traveling on Friday. There's no prak to travel on Friday. The prak is to travel the day Prophet told us. Sahih al-Bukhari and Ka'ab ibn Malik, radiallahu anhu, kana yaqul, laqallama, it is very rare to see Prophet Asama goes to travel, except he travels on the Thursdays. Illa yawm al-Khamis. He selects Thursday to travel. Except a few points. That's the most important point here in our lecture. A salat fi safari. What we do in the salah in our traveling? We divide the salah into sections. Number one, al-adhan. What do we do with the adhan when we are traveling? Is it required from us adhan or not? قال ابن باس الأذان فرض كفاية للصلاة. فرض كفاية means one person do أذان, not rest of them. If you are 50, so allow 50 of us to do أذان. Only one called فرض كفاية. If one does, we are not committing sin. That's why always in the masjid, only one person does the أذان. يجب على الجماعة. It's wajib upon the جماعة to do أذان. في الحضر وفي السفر when they are at home, they sit, or when they are traveling. Wajib upon them. So what's jama'ah? What's the minimum number of jama'ah?
Two.
Two. Two onwards? Yeah. If you are praying, wajib upon you. But if you are praying in a masjid, where jama'ah finished and there was adhan and iqamah, can do only iqamah. But if you are praying, where there is no adhan before you, it's wajib for you to look at jama'ah. If you don't do adhan in your salah, what happened to that salah? Is it authentic or not authentic your salah? Adhan is wajib. I didn't do adhan in your salah. So what's happening?
Salah is authentic.
Salah is authentic. It's not connected to the adhan. But you're committing, you're getting sin not to do adhan in jama'ah. And you adhira wahidu minhum wa yuqimul adhan. And one person is doing adhan and yaqam. هذا هو الصواب. This is the authentic. إنها فرض كفاية. إذا قام به واحد من الجماعة. And one person is doing it on behalf of the congregation. الوضوء. الوضوء. الصحيح الترمذي عن صفوان بن عسال قال كان رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم يأمرنا إذا كنا سفرا. الرسول صلى الله عليه وسلم used to command us when we are traveling. Allah ننزع خفافنا not to remove our خفين not only خف also socks جواري. There's four authentic hadiths, yes, talking about the جواري like a خفين. ثلاثة أيام ولياليهن, 3 days and 3 nights. You don't allow it, not, yes, don't remove your خفين except for sexual impurity, which you are getting shower. وَلَكِنْ مِنْ غَائِذٍ وَبَوْلٍ وَنَوْمٍ. If you go to relieve yourself, or urinate, or you sleep, don't remove yourself, your خفين. Test your problem, 3 days and 3 nights. Number three, when you are praying salah, talk about the Qiblah. Salah you divide into two. Farad and Sunnah. Yeah. Sahih Bukhari, Qala Salim. Who knows that Salim? He called Salim bin Abdullah bin Umar bin Khattab. He's one of the Fuqaha of Medina. He said, Kana Abdullah bin Umar. He talked about his dad. Yusalli ala dabati. He used to pray, yeah, whilst hiding, yeah, he's coming. Min al-layl huwa musafirin, in the night while he's traveling. ما يبالي, he doesn't bother حيث كان وجهه, whether he faced the Qibla or not. You are traveling, and you bring Sunnah, you can face anywhere. You can face anywhere. قال ابن عمر وقال رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم يسبح على راحلته قبل أي وجه توجه wherever it faces ويوتر عليها, and he prays his witr on her. قال أنه لا يصلي عليها المكتوبة, he doesn't pray فرد on she camel, yeah, when he's traveling. Why? Because you can't stop the camel, come down and then pray on, isn't it, on the floor, on the earth. But when you are on the flight in the airplane, you can't come out, isn't it? So in that case, you pray as Prophet ﷺ prayed the Sunnah. Now, istiqbal al-qibla. In the farad, it's wajib fil hadari. When you are at home, it's wajib upon you to face the qibla. In the farad and the nafar, Sunnah. For the traveling, it's wajib upon you, yeah, in the farad to face the qibla. We said wajib upon you to face the Qiblah in the Sunnah. Very clear that. رابعاً القصر في السفر. To shorten your salah while you are traveling. صحيح مسلم عن شعبة عن يحيى بن يزيد الهنائي قال سألت أنس بن مالك. I asked أنس بن مالك عن قصر الصلاة فقال كان رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم إذا خرج مسيرة 3 أميال. Prophet goes 3 miles, yeah, or 3 farsakh, he used to shorten him. He used to shorten him. That is what farsakh is, 3 miles, and a mile is where your sight ends. So a mile is when you see a person and you don't know whether that person is male or female. And you don't know whether they are coming to you or they're walking away from you. Yeah, that distance, that's the first time. Yeah. And they say roughly 1,680 meters. That means roughly 1.5 kilometers. First. Albani said, in the Qasr al-Mabda'uhu, you start in the Qasr of Salah, min ba'd al-khuruj min al-baldad, after you leave the city. You are not starting your Qasr while you are in the city. Now, in our city here, Heathrow is a part of London. The Gatwick and the Luton are not part of the London. When you are traveling and you reach them, you can bring your Qasr in there, because you left the city. While in the Heathrow, you didn't leave the city. You can't do Qasr in the Heathrow. So you see what is part of the city and what is not part of the city. As-sawm fi safari, fasting. Sahih Bukhari, Ibrahim Abu Ismail al-Saksakiyu, سمعت أبا بردة أبو بردة is a son of أبو موسى الأشعري واستحب هو ويزيد بن أبي كبشة two scholars يزيد بن أبي كبشة and أبو بردة they are traveling and one of the students called Ibrahim is traveling with them so he's learning from them he's learning from them he say Yazid bin Abi Kabsha He used to fast while he's traveling. Abu Burda said to him, I hear Abu Musa, that's his dad, miraran, several times, يقول, قال رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم, إذا مريض العبد, when the servant falls sick, or suffer or is traveling, كتب الله, has been written for him, ما كان يعمل. What the good deeds he used to do, مُقِيمًا صَحِيحًا while he is at home and he is in good health. You are at home and you are good health, whatever you do, that will be written for you if you are sick and you are unable to do it. Or if you are traveling and unable to do it. So don't fast. When you are at home, you used to fast Ramadan. But now you are traveling. So don't fast. You got same rewards. And then you do a qadha later on and you get extra rewards. So that means expect to break your fast. But when we are breaking our fast, what we said about salah, you can't shorten your salah unless you leave the city. قال الترمذي في سننه Imam Tirmidhi said, لِلْ مُسَافِرِ for the traveler, and يُفْتِرَ فِي بَيْتِهِ he breaks his iftar in his home قبل يخرج before he leaves the house. وليس له أن يقصر الصلاة but he can't shorten his salah حتى يخرج من جدار المدينة أو القرية until he leaves the city. You are traveling. Yeah. So your salah and your fasting. The two most important. Yeah. You fasting. Yes. You should break before you leave. You should break before you leave at home. But salah, you can't shorten until you leave the city. Oh, قول إسحاق بن إبراهيم الحنظلي. He said the evidence عن محمد بن كعب أنه قال أتيت أنس بن مالك محمد بن كعب young companion. He came to Anas bin Malik in Ramadan. Oh, you reach suffering. And he was preparing to travel. Anas bin Malik. وقد روح إلى الله راحلته and he she كمل has been prepared. ولبس ثياب السفر and he's wearing the traveling clothes. What's left for him? Nothing. He's leaving now at home, from home. فدعا بدعام فأكل. He asked them to give him food and he ate. So he broke his fasting before he leave home. فقلت له محمد سلاح محمد بن كعب then from Anas سنة is this sunnah what you've done. He said, Sunnatun, it's a sunnah to do that. So Marakiwa and then he mounted. Yeah. He rode his mountain. That means, yeah, when we are traveling, it's better to break iftar. You're fasting and you're breaking at your home before you leave. When it comes to the salah, you are not doing shortening your salah until you leave, that's it. That's very clear, inshallah. The last one, استعجال الرجوع حتى في الحج. When you are traveling, try to come back as early as possible to the family. Don't delay. Try to come back as early as possible. Don't delay. Especially Hajj. When people go to Hajj, say, I love to stay after Hajj at time, enjoying the Kaaba, enjoying this. No. Hadith mutafaqun alayhi, and Abu Hurayra radiallahu anhu, and Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, as-safaru qid'atun min al-'adhab. You have seen that part of the Hadith. Yamna'u ahadakum ta'amahu wa sharabahu wa nawmahu. You have seen that part of the Hadith in the previous section of the lecture. For that, فَإِذَا قَضَى أَحَدَكُمْ نَحْمَدَهُ. When you finish the reason or the purpose of your journey. When you finish the reason or the purpose of your journey, فَلْيُعَجِّلْ إِلَىٰ أَهْلِهِ. He should return to his family as quick as possible, as early as possible. Don't delay. Even Hajj. Another hadith, Aisha said, and Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, إِذَا قَضَى أَحَدُكُمْ حَجَّهُ. When one of you spent his Hajj, finished his Hajj, فَلْيُعَجِّلَ الرِّحْلَةَ إِلَىٰ أَهْلِهِ. He should hasten to come back to his family. Why? فَإِنَّهُ to come back as early as possible. أَعَظَمُ لِأَجْرِهِ. That's a greater in his rewards. Yeah. So whenever you travel to, try to come back as early as possible. When you finish the reason, the purpose of traveling. We didn't know traveling for the relaxation. Traveling to see the world. Go to a blue mosque, go to the Fir'aun, go to this. The travel of the commandments were ibadah. The travel of the commandments were ibadah. If you want to go to your family to visit them, that's part of ibadah. That's part of ibadah. You are traveling to see a brother who is sick in another city, that's ibadah. But going to a blue mosque or this or that, that's not ibadah. So you should be careful. So when you travel and you finish the purpose of your traveling, you should come back as early as possible. Don't delay. That's when you can get more rewards. Even the Hajj, go to Mecca, spend the Haram, 100,000 times Salah. When you finish your Hajj, don't waste your time there. Because to come back earlier, as quicker, to your family, that's where you can get more rewards. That's where you can get more rewards. Subhanallah, alhamdulillah, ashhadu an la ilaha illa anta, astaghfiruka wa atubu ilayk. Wa sallallahu wa sallam ala nabiyyina wa ala alihi wa sahbihi. Wa man tabi'ahum bi ihsanin ila yawmiddin.